Welcome. Welcome, my dear friends. Myself, Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande would like to welcome you all in my Ayurveda Academy YouTube channel. This channel is for medical students. This channel is for professors. This channel is for the doctors. This channel is for the common man. And this channel is for patients. So this is all compassing channel. This is the channel's specialty. Because some people are making only for the student, some people are only for the making money, some people only for the patient. But I am making this sharing of knowledge for all sectors in the field of medicine. Okay. So this particular serial is related with Ayurvedic medicinal plants. First, to begin with, I have discussed, this is nearly the last, the plant in the series of 30 important Ayurvedic medicinal plants. So my dear friends, please check whether you have seen all my 30 videos in this particular serial of Ayurvedic medicinal plants. I have already discussed 29 plants and I have already uploaded those videos. So I request all of you, please see these videos hundreds of times and enjoy the utility of Ayurvedic medicinal plants. Okay. So myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Raghuveera Deshpande. I am MD, Doctor of Medicine in Ayurvedic Medicine, that is Kaya Chikitsa, and MD in Ayurvedic Physiology, that is Kriya Sharira. You can communicate to me, sorry, not by phone, but WhatsApp, text and audio messages 9226810630. This is my mobile and WhatsApp number the same. Okay. Let us discuss about very powerful plant. Yes, powerful plant. Why? Because this is under the group of Saudhnya Prabodhana. Please write down this word. Saudhnya Prabodhana. Saudhnya Prabodhana. If the patient is unconscious and if you give the smell of vaja, he can get up. It is possible. Because it is very strong stimulant fragrance and aroma. But this plant is so good in Saudhnya Prabodhana. One of my great teacher, Vaidya Bhapu Nanal, he is no more right now, but he is one of the renowned faculty of Ayurveda, stalwart of Ayurveda, Vaidya Bhapu Nanal, sir. He has taught that vacha can stimulate to even degenerating, and what is, you can see the cells which are going to die, that can be stimulated back to by the use of vacha internally or sometimes externally. For example, numbness of the hands, diabetic neuropathy, you have to just rub little rubbing because it is hot. If you rub like this, oh, then burning. You have to just apply. So vacha or the vaikhand powder is kafagna and stimulant to the conduction of nerves. Okay. Conduction or stimulation to the cells which are going to die. Liver failure, cardiac failure, kidney failure, brain failure. You can use by skillful tag the vacha, the different products of vacha, or simple vacha churn or powder, very, very little. You can use with the honey and the ghee together, but not in equal amount. Synonyms. What a paryayi naam in Sanskrit. What is the use of paryayi naam? Different. Why the different names we should know? Because these names can give you the idea about some properties of the plant, benefits of the plant, uses of the plant, or structure of the plant, morphology of the plant. Ugra, vacha, synonym ugra. Ugra means strong. This plant, after ingestion, gives irritation to the tongue, even the stomach. So be careful for the pitta people. Whenever there is a pitta problem, pittam sasne sneho, ushna tikshna, pitta is hot and penetrating. Vacha is not for pitta. Be careful if you are having pitta prakriti. If you are having gastritis, if you are having peptic ulcer, if you have bleeding disorders, blood RBCs are breaking, You are suffering from ITP, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura, thalassemia, blood transfusion. No, no, no. Be careful from the vacha. Vacha is very, very hot. Okay? Hot and hit. Ushna and tikshna property. Then ugragandha. Very strong smell. That is why it is saudhnya prabodhana. Saudhnya is your consciousness. It will come up. The patient will come up from the drowsy and unconscious state to the conscious if it is under the control with the different medicines, not only with the vacha. Try to understand. Vacha is also called as a calamus. German word is calamus. Calamus. German word. I have visited to the America, Switzerland, Germany, Italy, Spain, 1993 to 2014. 20 years I have visited for the Ayurvedic propagation. Yes, that is the God's fortune. Calamus and sweet flag. Sweet flag, the another word for vacha. It is originated in Europe. Yes, I have visited to Spain, Germany, Italy, and many hundreds, thousands of patients I have seen, these European patients. They are using this vacha, vekhanda, sweet flag. Vacha powder is mixed with the ghee. It is given ritually in India to the newborn babies on the seventh day to improve the intellect and speech development. Speech development. Vacha, Latin name, Acorus calamus. This is herb. Useful part, Upayukta anga rhizome. Each and every Ayurvedic medicinal herb should be discussed on the basis of basic principle of Dravya Guna Vijnana. What is that principle? Siddhanta kya hai? Rasa, Vipak, Virya, Prabhava, Siddhanta. Rasa, Virya, Vipak, Siddhanta. This is very popular. This is always important for your examination. Okay? Because medicinal plant actions are depend either on Rasa or on the Vipak or on the Virya or on the Prabhava. Okay? So Rasa, Tikta, Katu. Tikta is bitter, katu is a pungent, spicy. Vipak is katu and virya is hot, ushna. Prabhava, extraordinary power. Extraordinary function. That is called as prabhava in Ayurveda. Why? Because there are so many plants having tikta, katu, ushna. Tikta ras, katu vipak, ushna virya. Lots of plants are there. Plants are there. But why not all the plants are medhya for the brain, brain tonic? Why vacha is medhya, stimulant to the your intelligence? Whenever there is a low intelligent quotient, low IQ, then only you can use the vacha to stimulate the sensory system and the motor system in the brain. Okay, so if there is a deafness, if there is aphasia, if there is a speech problem, you can definitely use, you can try for vacha. Guna, properties, laghu, medhya, this is a brain, this is brain, intelligence, medha, in Ayurveda, what is medha? In one word, grantha, avadharana shakti is equal to medha, grantha avadharana shakti is equal to medha. Remember this thing, understanding capacity, how much Dr. Deshpande's lecture is going in my brain, that is your medha. Then guna, properties, laghu, tikshna and ushna. Effect, basically it is acting on vata and kapha dosha. But be cautious. This is pitta prakopak. Don't use whenever there is a burning, whenever there is a gastritis, whenever there is an inflammation, whenever there is a bleeding, don't use vacha. Strict warning by Professor Deshpande. Why in the vata and kapha? Because vata and kapha, both the doshas, bioenergies, are having shita guna common. I will chant the shloka. What is the vata shloka? Tatra ruksho laghu shitaha kharasukshmash chalo nilaha. Anilaha means vata dosha. Pittam sasneha tikshna ushna visra saradrava. But I am talking about kapha. Snigdaha shito gururmandaha. Shlakshna, Sandra, Mrudasthiraha. So, in Vata and Kapha, both are Sheetha properties. Stambane Sheetha, Stroto Rodha. That will be removed. Stroto Rodha will be removed. Body channels will be cleaned up. Detoxification, cleansing effect obstruction will be relieved by the vacha. That is why saudhnya, senses, prabodhana, evoke, it will stimulate to your brain cells. Dhatu, it acts on the rakta dhatu, samata, samata, kafagata rakta, okay? Or I'm sorry, rakta gata kafa. Then you can use the vacha. Mausa, mausa gata kafa, heaviness, fibrosis, stiffness, vacha is useful. But not in the atrophy. Not in the atrophy, in kshaya, no vacha. Mausa kshaya, atrophy, no vacha. Mausa vruddhi, yes, vacha. Medo vruddhi, yes, vacha. Santarpana janya vyadhi in Ayurveda. Overnutrition, then vacha is useful. But if there is a medo kshaya, cachexia, weight loss, no vacha. No use of vacha plant. Very clear. Majja, here, nerves, brain. Whenever there is a stagnation, hydrocephalus, for example, whenever there is a obstruction in your brain cells, then you, but brain hemorrhage, no vacha. In brain hemorrhage, no vacha. In atrophy of the cerebrum, no vacha. If you, you can use in atrophy, but little bit with the ghee and very little in amount, okay? Srotas, it is acting on majjava srotas, annava srotas, rasraktava srotas, pranava, respiratory system, and shukrava srotas. Everywhere, it will make the detoxification. Srotorodha will be removed with the help of vacha. Ama will be digested. Toxins. Vacha pacifies the vata dosha by its ushna virya, hot potency. Vacha increases the agni, digestive fire, metabolism stimulant, enzyme creation, and reduces the ama. Ama is a toxin created due to faulty digestion or faulty metabolism. Vacha shows its action on the brain because of the tikta rasa. Vacha is useful in respiratory system, pranava srotas, for example, in common cold, pharyngitis, laryngitis, here, sore throat, asthma with a lot of cough, profusion, cough, expectoration, kaphaja kasa, and chest pain because of the indigestion, then vacha can be used. If there is a lot of gas, lot of indigestion, heaviness in the stomach, heaviness in the body, amavastha is there, use the vacha. It will act as a mucolytic, pichilatva, styanatva will be removed of kapha dosha because of the katurasa. In Vasanta Rutu, in the spring season, Ayurvedic doctors always advise the Vamana Chikitsa, Panchakarma, therapeutic vomiting. And there we use some medicines as a Vamaka Churna, which can use the therapeutic vomiting. That particular powder contains Madana Phala Churna, 3 gram, Yashti Madhu or Jeshta Madha or licorice powder, 2 gram, and vacha only 1 gram. This mixture is mixed with the honey and used as a leaking material, chatana in Ayurveda. Then Vasantik Vaman is given with this Vamachurna and Vamanopagadravya like licorice decoction or sugarcane juice. Vacha as a preventive. Vacha powder is usually applied on the chest, not rubbing, because if you do the rubbing, it will cause inflammatory changes on the skin, pustules, papules will be developed, erythema will be developed, bleeding will occur, don't rub, okay? Neck and back region after the bath to the infant, especially in the rainy and winter season, vacha can be used, but in summer season, don't use vacha. In pitta dominant children, don't use vacha. If delicate skin is there, skin rash is already there, don't use vacha. Vacha gives the protection from shvasa, bronchial asthma, kasa, kaphaja kasa. Vacha is answer for respiratory allergy. This is spring allergy. Can you see? Achim! Achim! Allergy. Sneezing. Okay. Vacha oil. Fantastic. Is used as an application, internal application. It is not as a drops. In allergic rhinitis, of pollen, grape pollen, dust and fume, the patient can apply vacha oil inside the nostril going before going out of the house as a preventive measure. You can bring the vacha oil from the market. Cut your nails, sterile, purify, and then take it 2 drops over here, vacha oil, this little finger, and then apply like this before going out of the house so that you can prevent from allergic rhinitis. You can try it. Very simple. Then vacha in mano vah srotas, mind, limbic system in the brain. In chronic diseases like psychological status, whenever there is a disturb, vacha is a choice offered to maintain the harmony between the body-mind complex. In the depression cases, vacha powder is used for pradhamanasya. It's like a powder. Pradhamanasya. Okay. Vacha for majjadhatu. Vacha improves the cognitive functions due to its thick tarasa and its action on majjadhatu nervous system. With Ayurvedic tradition, vacha and gold with honey is given intermittently to a child from the range of less than 2 years old as a medhya rasayana. Medhya rasayana is a brain tonic. Vacha for medha and buddhi. Can you see the Einstein? Yes. This is vacha stimulate the brain cells for proper development of intelligence, proper development of speech, and proper development of memory. Vacha for vak sanga, the literary meaning of vacha. Vacha is related with vak. Vak means I am talking. This is speech. Okay. So vacha can be helpful also in the problem related with speech like stammering. Stammer, you know the stammering. Vacha for udvartana, because this is the best lekhana, scrapping of excessive adipose tissue, excessive obesity, kaphaja prakruti, srotorodha should be there. Vacha powder is used as udvartana, dry powder massage, as it stimulates the agni on rubbing locally on the skin. But usually it is mixed with the some another powder like rasna or even turmeric. There is a typical measure. Okay. Don't use directly only vacha on your body. Never try this. Huh? It will cause erythema, inflammation, redness. And you will call me, oh, doctor, what you have told me? No. It should be done under doctor's supervision only. Don't try rubbing off vacha off your own. This is the strict warning to my viewers. But what you can say, the warning with love. Okay. It is used for obesity treatment for losing the fat. Caution. This is very important. Carefully used in pitta biotype, pitta prakriti, pitta predominant symptoms like burning, inflammation, bleeding, or any diseases. Weak patients who have already lost the body components. Dhatu kshayajanya vata prakop, never use the vacha. Bleeding tendency, no vacha. Burning sensation, no vacha. Burning urine, no. Vacha kalpa products, saraswata churna, as a rasayana drug, 1 teaspoon with ghee. Saraswata arishta liquids is available, 4 teaspoon. BD means morning and evening, after lunch, after dinner, with equal amount of water. Medhya rasayana, which contains vacha, 1 teaspoon in the morning, as a rasayana kal with the breakfast. Brahmi prash, 2 TSF teaspoon in the morning, 2 teaspoon in the evening. Vacha oil, as I have told, for the application. Vacha churna for pradhamana nasya, and external application to the chest, throat and forehead. So this is vacha churna available in the market. This is saraswata churna from Baidyanath. This is saraswata arishta is available. Then medhya rasayana is also available. Brahmi prash syrup is available, and vacha tel is also available. So my dear friends, this is all about this particular plant, and I wish you all the best. But try to understand, kaunsi bhi bimari mein yatha avashyak yatha kal vaidyakiya salah lena bahut hi zarur hai. If you are suffering from epilepsy, hysteria, low intelligent quotient, hyperactive children, you can visit to the nearby Ayurvedic vaidya or the doctor and Ayurvedic hospital. If you don't find anything, Ayurveda Academy has a lot of doctors and lot of professors. You can contact Professor Deshpande by WhatsApp text or audio message by 9226810630. But at the end, as usual, I want to request you, your support is very much valuable for me. Try to understand my feelings. So please like this video, share this video, and ask everybody of your friend to subscribe my YouTube channel. I wish you all the best. Please take care. Bye-bye. Sarve api sukhina santu, sarve santu niramaya. Wish you happy, healthy, and long life.